where we have to report a cop was busted for being a predator. An investigation led by the Tennessee Bureau of Investigation has resulted in Sharquawn Henderson, a former Dyersburg police officer, being accused of having inappropriate sexual contact with a minor. 29th Judicial District Attorney General Danny Goodman initiated the investigation. On February 23rd, at the request of 29th Judicial District Attorney General Danny Goodman, TBI special agents began investigating allegations involving 29-year-old Sharquawn Henderson. During the course of the investigation, agents developed information that Henderson, while employed as an officer of the Dyersburg Police Department, engaged in sexual activity with a juvenile in Dyer County. On April 10th, the Dyer County Grand Jury returned indictments charging Henderson with soliciting sexual exploitation of a minor by electronic means and aggravated statutory rape. On Tuesday, Henderson surrendered to TBI agents at the Dyer County Jail and was booked on $10,000 bond. Well, this is sick and twisted. I always hate, and I understand that this was just a police document where they're saying that they were investigating inappropriate sexual activity with a minor, because it takes me to my news anchor days where things would be written and come across the teleprompter that would say, today's story about an inappropriate relationship between a teacher and a student. It's not an inappropriate relationship is when you kiss your friend's boyfriend. Okay. It's not sex between an adult and a child. That's called rape. And I think we've conditioned ourselves to downplay it or say it softer when it should be said aggressively, as aggressive and violent as the act is. This is someone who was put up in a position of power, someone who was supposed to protect and serve. And here we are again with a mugshot and disgusting acts outlined in an indictment. What say you about this one, Jessica?
I feel like so frequently we hear about those responsible for enforcing the laws being the ones who break them. And we could talk about that ad nauseum, but all I'll say right now is law and justice are not the same. And to focus on people using their positions of power to abuse children, to rape children, it is mind-boggling to me that that's what you want to use your power for. Why is someone in that position? Why does someone have that mentality? Why are we not putting more resources into exploring how someone gets to that point and preventing it? Because it's very difficult after the fact to say, oh, well, our officer did something bad. Are we going to investigate him? What will the consequences be? Because oftentimes when someone's in a position of power, there are not systems in place to hold them accountable. We've got to do something about addressing the problem at its root. But I think you're absolutely right that we need to talk about this with the gravity of how serious this issue is. And it's always people in power that are saying, well, you know, it's an inappropriate relationship. Where do we draw the line of consent? Women are maturing so much faster than they used to. And they're talking about little girls. They're talking about minors. They're making excuses for a power dynamic where it's a child who doesn't know what's going on, or even if they do consent, what they are consenting to and why. We really need to investigate this thoroughly. We still have on the books in many states across the United States that it's legal to have child brides. And it's a distraction that people are talking about, you know, the LGBTQ plus community and transgender community as the source of this.
I think you're exactly right. And I don't know, there's states and people in power who think a 12-year-old should be married off and that's just fine.